Hello and welcome back to another video for Final Fantasy XIV housing with me, Meoni. Today we're looking at the Sil'dihn set. Now I looked at one of these items previously in another video. We looked specifically at the Sil'dihn kitchen shelf, which is something I managed to get that dropped from the variant mode dungeon of the Sil'dihn Subterran. As you can see, I did a varied amount of runs of that. Many runs, in fact. It's a really fun little activity. I'm looking forward to the future variant and criterion dungeons they add in the future. But that was one of the things I got from a chest, specifically one of the loot chests inside there between bosses, as well as on bosses it can drop as well. But additionally, what I didn't have at the time of that video was the other items. So there's also a table and chairs that drop. So what I've gone and done is I've spent gil to buy these from other players, because all of this is market tradable, obviously, but you can also get these from inside the variant modes. They seem to be a fairly low drop chance. I've not seen any of these other items personally, and I only saw one kitchen shelf in my entire completion of that, which was many runs, like I say, over 20 runs of variant mode. So we're going to look at what the chairs and table look like. Firstly, the chairs say a wooden chair crafted in the Sil'dihn style. And the table says a small table crafted in the Sil'dihn style. So this is what these look like. They're, of course, furnished dyeable. We're going to put all this together. I thought it would be better to get two chairs because it would look weird without it. So it kind of reminds me of one of those... let's just put snap to grid on so that we can get a nice... Oh, look at that. Perfect center. Nice perfect center view. So this is the table. We'll plop the chairs out as well, either side. That would be good, wouldn't it? I think we'll have one there, and we'll have the other one over here, and rotate that nice like that. Very nice, very cool stuff. And bring that a little bit closer. Yes, excellent stuff. All right. So this is what we have to deal with. Let's go in first person mode and have a look at these items. So they are actually really beautiful chairs and tables, aren't they? I love the sort of brass tablecloth here, or whatever this might be called. We also have brass on the outside of these deck chairs. These are very, very old design chairs. They're supposed to look old because of where we saw them inside the variant mode. I don't want to give too much away in terms of the lore storyline behind all of that, because it's quite thick, and that's probably for another video. But yeah, these are from a very, very long time ago in terms of the storyline, the date of the world sort of thing. It's very nice, isn't it? Very nice collection. It's nice to have all of the bits, and I don't think you could get away with just having one table and one chair, because it would look a bit strange. Of course, the kitchen shelf isn't a tabletop item. So you're not going to be able to put this on the table. It's also, as you remember, very small. And yeah, I still don't like this item. I don't think it fits in with the rest of this. It's like a floor thing. It should have been table mounted, in my opinion. I really think they should have table mounted that. Anyway, let's look at the dyeability of this furniture. That's one of the other reasons we're here. So let's have a look at a chair, first of all. So the chairs, the fabric is what's going to die. So not the wood and not the brass. We have a variety of colors, but we always get this gold stitching down the center of whatever cushion we change. I like the black cushions, actually. It looks better than the washed out sort of grays that you originally get. Yeah, looks quite nice. I quite like the red as well. It depends what you want to use, you know, in terms of what room you're going for. But these have a varied application, as you can imagine, to really make things pop. I don't see many people with these chairs yet either in their areas. Honestly, I kind of wish that these were outdoor items, considering where we see these in a Sil'dihn Subterran are outside, kind of in an open area. And we sorely need more outdoors furnishings, and especially chairs. I don't think we really have any outdoors chairs, like deck chairs and things. Only a couple, right? So, yeah, these would be nice. I like the regal sort of colors that you get with midnight blue. Look at that. Very cool stuff. I do like that. So, yeah, all in all, not too bad. as I expected. So I would imagine that the tablecloth is going to be what's dyeable on the table. So let's have a look at that. Yes, exactly the same. So it's the same texture, basically, as the chairs, for the most part. Looks good in dark colours. Yeah, it's because of the gold. Gold and black has always gone well together. I will say, when you do dye this, the pixelation around the top, it really looks like they need like anti-aliasing or something on this texture. That's quite awful, isn't it? But it is what it is, you know. It is what it is. I like the red and gold. From a distance, this is going to look great. Up close, it's quite ugly, I think, personally. The weaker part of the set. But of course, yeah, what can you do at the end of the day? Very cool stuff. I don't know if, you know, people are going to use this for their indoor cafe spaces. I know some people have been looking for some different furniture because everybody goes for, like, the Glade set or whatever. So it is nice to have a good variety. Me personally, I would probably get these, dye them jet black, and then put 100 of them near a stage and then have like a comedy club or something. I really despise this tea set thing at the back. I think that that should have been a tabletop item or something. It just looks weird. But yeah, really cool stuff. In terms of sitting on these items, just to check that they are, of course, fully functional and the correct height, because sometimes we've had chairs put into the game that are the incorrect height and it looks really strange. But yeah, it looks like they've done some good quality control here. Excellent stuff. Anyway, let me know if you've got the Sil'dihn set yourself, if you plan to utilize this, and yeah, what you think about the quality of that tablecloth. And I'll see you all next time. Bye bye.